Did you know that Cloudflare protects at least 20% of all websites? That's a lot of sites, which is great for security, but challenging for web scraping. Don't worry though, I've got some tips to help you. First off, what exactly is Cloudflare, and why do so many websites use it? Cloudflare is a security service that acts as a shield for websites. It sits between you and web pages and filters incoming traffic to block bots, prevent attacks, and speed up content delivery. But here's the catch. Cloudflare generally assumes that any unrecognized bot traffic is dangerous. So, even if your intent is harmless, your scraper can still get locked out. And what indicates you've been blocked? If you try to scrape a protected website, you'll often see a 403 forbidden error code. Here are some other common error codes and what they mean. So, how exactly does Cloudflare block scrapers? It has a few clever tricks to detect and filter out automated traffic, starting with some passive techniques. IP address fingerprinting. Every request you send reveals the IP address that's tied to your device. You'll be immediately blocked if too many requests come from the same IP. The same goes for requests from VPNs or some data center proxies, which don't have a real user reputation. HTTP request details. Cloudflare also analyzes HTTP headers, looking at details like your browser type, language, and operating system. If anything seems out of the ordinary, Cloudflare flags the request as automated. TLS fingerprinting. TLS, or Transport Layer Security, secure your connection to a website. During this connection, a unique sequence called the TLS handshake occurs. Cloudflare studies this handshake pattern. If it's different from a typical browser, Cloudflare flags it as suspicious. These are the passive techniques, but some of Cloudflare's defenses are active, like JavaScript challenges. Cloudflare can send a quick JavaScript test to your browser to verify it's operated by a real person, not a bot. Most browsers pass easily, while many bots get stuck here. CAPTCHA prompts. When Cloudflare detects unusual behavior, like rapid or repetitive requests, it can trigger a CAPTCHA. CAPTCHAs are simple visual or interactive tasks designed to tell humans and bots apart. Sometimes, it's as simple as sticking the "I'm not a robot" box, so humans can handle these just fine, but bots usually fail. Event tracking. Finally, Cloudflare tracks user interactions on a page, like mouse movements, scrolling, and clicks. Human visitors create natural interaction patterns, while bots struggle to mimic this. When Cloudflare doesn't see realistic engagement, it's another signal that a scraper might be in play. Have you ever encountered any of these security checks when browsing or web scraping? Let us know in the comments below, and let's see which is the most common. Now, let's get into practical tips for bypassing Cloudflare restrictions. One of the most effective ways to bypass Cloudflare is to rotate IP addresses, ideally using residential proxies. Unlike data center proxies, residential ones are tied to actual devices and locations, making them appear more like real users. A proxy service gives a new IP address with each request or after a set number of requests. Our proxies also allow sticky sessions, where the same IP is used for a brief period to mimic an actual browsing session, which can prevent detection. JavaScript challenges are a tough hurdle for many scrapers. This is where Puppeteer comes in handy. Puppeteer is a browser automation tool that can simulate user actions and interact with JavaScript pages. It opens a headless browser, solves the JavaScript challenges in real time, and lets you capture the data after the page loads. Another key ingredient in bypassing Cloudflare is CAPTCHA solvers. For scraping at scale, these tools can help keep your sessions active even when Cloudflare prompts a CAPTCHA. Just keep in mind that these solutions come with added costs and aren't foolproof. So, it's smarter and cheaper to use techniques like IP rotation to reduce the chances of CAPTCHAs showing up in the first place. To increase your web scraping efficiency, mimic real user behavior. Program your scraper to add slight, random delays between requests, scroll, and interact with elements. This helps avoid Cloudflare's detection mechanisms. Make sure your requests have realistic headers and user agents to avoid looking like a bot. Standard headers like accept language and refer can make your scraper appear more like a regular browser. Last, manage your TLS fingerprint. Cloudflare detects bots through unusual TLS handshakes, so using tools like Puppeteer or Playwright to match TLS fingerprints with common browsers can reduce suspicion. Before we wrap up, I'd love to hear any tips or tools you found helpful for bypassing Cloudflare protection. Drop them in the comments below for others to see. And if you're looking for the fastest residential proxies to help with your scraping tasks, check out the link in the description. A 3-day free trial is available, so you can try them out risk-free.